a new one. How are you, mate?
How are you, mate?
Good to see you, mate.
It's good, isn't it?
It is, isn't it? How are you? Good to see you, mate.
Lovely.
Thank you everyone for joining us here in London ahead of Thursday night's huge JDNXTGEN show. It's been an unbelievable year, and what a way to finish. This and Friday night in Phoenix, Arizona, we start with the JDNXTGEN card with this whole host of talent. 38 shows promoted already this year with 350 fights, 38 world title fights, and a lot of these guys, girls here today, that's where they want to be in the next year, world title fights. And these are all the future of the big cards we have coming up. It's been an exciting year, and we look forward to finishing it at York Hall. A stacked card from top to bottom, and we'll start with some of our debutants on Saturday night joining us. Unfortunately, Ibrahim Nadim couldn't make it, the Ricky Hatton trained star. He'll be here tomorrow for the weigh-in. But starting with some of our other talent here. So, Dante, good to have you here. Thanks for making a trip down to London already. Managed by Billy Joe Saunders and MTK. Looking forward to your second fight, actually, isn't it? You've had your professional debut now.
Yeah, it's my second fight. I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to putting on a very good performance.
And obviously, managed by Billy Joe Saunders, do you think that helps your career? You know, you're around a good group of people, and do you think that will help you speed up the process as you're in the pro ranks now?
Yeah, I feel it would speed up the process because Billy Joe Saunders is a big name in boxing. He's got a lot of connections, so I'll be up there soon as well. Thank you.
Thanks very much, mate. Looking forward to seeing you on Thursday night for your second fight. Malik's first press conference. It's all right, mate, though. Over to you, Franklin. So heavyweight, great time to be in the heavyweight division, exciting period, lots of big fights out there. It is your pro debut on Thursday. How are you feeling ahead of that?
Yeah, I'm feeling good. Excited, definitely, and I'm ready.
Anything else?
No, that's it. I feel good. I'm enjoying the occasion.
I'm not as good as Eddie at this, so you got to try and help me out. Obviously, former London ABA champion, Haringey Box Cup winner. Do you feel like moving into the pro ranks is the right time for you? Good amateur career and now coming through to the pros?
Yeah, 100%. I feel like my amateur career definitely helped, but I feel like the most important thing for me has been just learning, you know, getting the right experience with different fighters, and it's been an enlightening period, but I'm enjoying it, and I know I'm ready to show what I got.
Thanks very much, mate. Look forward to seeing you on Thursday. Over to you, Malik. Malik, obviously close with Anthony Joshua. You've had 10 amateur fights, and this is your, again, pro debut. Looking forward to getting out there at York Hall. You know, some of the biggest names have fought there. Are you looking forward to starting your career there on Thursday?
Yeah, 100%. It's been a long camp. I come back in September because I went out to the fight in New York. So when I come back, I started camp. It's been a long camp, and I'm just ready to go now. So I had good sparring, sparred a lot of the lads that are up here. So, yeah, I'm just ready.
Again, do you feel having the support of Anthony Joshua, obviously coming back, what he's done for the sport and what he's done for British boxing, do you feel that will help you with your pro career, having him behind you?
100%. You know, from day one, when I started boxing at Finchley, he just always helped me, whatever I needed. He's been there as a role model as well. So it was happy to. I wanted to go out to Saudi, but I didn't want to come back and be jet lagged. But I was happy that he got the straps back, got the belts back. So it puts me in a good mood as well before my debut. So yeah.
Perfect. Thanks very much. Looking forward to having you there. Shannon, over to you. Obviously coming off the back of a good win, tough fight at the O2, and back in now quickly before the end of the year. Looking forward to ending. I think this is your fifth fight, so four good wins this year. Looking forward to ending the year with another big win.
Yeah, it's been a perfect first year as a professional. You know, four wins. My last fight was definitely a very good learning curve. She come out flying, but we dealt with it and showed another tool that I can do when needs boxing. But I'm looking forward to have my first ever stoppage at York Hall, so it'd be nice to finish the year there, hopefully get another win and then start actually thinking about Christmas, because right now I don't think I've ever been so focused, not since my debut. I'm so focused on this fight, it's a little bit beyond a joke. I'm just so, I'm ready for it now.
Perfect. Obviously, this is your professional first year as a professional. Do you feel there's some big fights there for you in 2020?
Yeah, obviously, I'm not going to look past Thursday, because you should never look past your first fight. That's a big mistake. Your next fight, that's a big mistake. But I do believe, God willing, I'll come through Thursday with a win. Next year will be a massive year. Start stepping up opponents, start looking at titles, and start really making a name for myself.
Perfect. Thanks very much, Shannon. And on to our top table here. Again, a whole host of talent up here and some great fights. We'll start with a fight between Craig Richards and Chad Sugden. Obviously, Craig's had a great year, some good wins in 2019, and he looks forward to an exciting 2020 with some big fights. Chad, do you feel that you can be the man standing in his way? Obviously, a big year ahead for Craig, but do you feel like you've got the skill and ability to go in there and stand in Craig's way?
Yeah, for sure. I won't be here for any other reason. I believe I can beat Craig. I've got all the tools to beat him. I just got to put it to show on Thursday night.
And obviously, Craig, as I said, has had a great year this year. Built, you know, got some good wins, and you could really use this as a launch pad for yourself now on Sky.
Oh, 100%. Yeah, 100%. He's number 4 in the UK on Boxrec, and he's got a world ranking in WBA. It's a massive fight for me, but it's a fight that I've took for one reason only, and that's to come and win.
Perfect. Thanks very much. Craig, as always, great to have you here.
Thanks.
Exciting 2019 so far. How do you feel ahead of Thursday night and then a big 2020 ahead?
Yeah, afternoon, everyone. I'm just looking forward to getting out on Thursday night. You know, it's been a while since I've been back out. You know, I'm just focused on this Thursday. I know that Chad, I think a few months ago, I think I saw him tag me in a post. I think he called me out before, so I know that he's going to come. He's willing for the big opportunity, and I'm not going to take him lightly. So, yeah, I'm just looking forward to going out Thursday night and making a statement, and then going on after that, and God willing, cleaning up the rest of the division.
As you say, some big fights out there for you in 2020. Who are you looking for next year?
Do you know what? I'm just focused on Thursday night. What I'm focused on next year is the titles. I want to make sure I go out after this, God willing, get through Thursday, and then go out and get that British title after that and have a big year. So it's just about ticking them all off. It's the first time I'm having a fight with another guy who's from Britain, believes in himself, and someone who believes he can beat me. It'll be my third one this year. This time's obviously not a grudge match like the other two, but I'm looking to go out and deliver a good performance.
Perfect. Look forward to that fight on Saturday. That's the first of our fights on our Sky card on Thursday night. Sorry. Now we're going to our first title fight, the big fight between Luther Clay and Freddie Kuett. Freddie, big fight for you on the Sky platform to get out there and build a name for yourself. Do you feel this fight has come a little bit too early for Luther, or do you see it as a tough test on Thursday?
No, I don't think it's too early. I think it's exactly at the right time. I think it's just God's timing. I had a great year, and this is my fourth fight in the third country, and my third title fight as well. So I'm really looking forward for this fight.
And obviously a big win, this fight for a WBO, one of the WBO belts, help you build up in the rankings for some big fights in 2020?
Yes, correct. I won the WBO European beginning of the year, so this will just add another one to the collection, and I'm just I just need to win this fight, like, regardless. This is my purpose, and then, like, he's just on the way to where I want to be, and you know, this is just my time now.
Perfect. And Luther, huge opportunity for you on Thursday to go out there in front of a huge audience on Sky and build a real name for yourself. How are you feeling?
Yeah, I'm feeling good, ready to go, and ready to defend my title. You know, the guy I won the title off didn't want to fight Freddie. He said, I'll fight Luther, it was an easier fight. Well, then he got touched up, so now I'm coming for Freddie.
And what are the big fights you're looking forward to in 2020, or are you not looking past Thursday night?
Nah, I ain't looking past Freddie. Freddie's a very good fighter. You know, his last fight where he won the WBO European was against Freddie Gallagher, a very good fighter. So can't afford to look past him, but I am going to go through him.
Okay, perfect. Look forward to that one. Kieran, great to have you here. Unfortunately, your opponent, Craig O'Brien, couldn't be here today, but it's a... It's been an exciting year for you. Obviously, you had your comeback fight a few months ago. You know, felt good, looked really strong in that fight. How are you feeling being back at York Hall on Thursday?
I'm excited to be back at York Hall. I'm excited for the fight. I feel really good coming into this one. I just want to get the job done. I'm not overlooking him, but I want to get the job done and get one step closer to that British title again.
And obviously you built a good name for yourself this year, and you take that into 2020 for some big fights next year.
Yeah, hopefully I get some big fights next year. And like I said, I want to go back and fight for that British title.
Perfect, look forward to it. And now on to our main event of the night, Richard Riakporhe against Jack Massey. A huge fight for the domestic cruiserweight division. Both of these guys can go out there and go on to 2020 as the number one name, with Lawrence Okolie moving on now for the WBO, vacant WBO title soon. This is a massive fight for these guys to move on, step forward as the number one in the domestic division. We'll start with Jack. Jack, obviously you were supposed to fight Lawrence Okolie earlier this year. Unfortunately, had an injury. Do you feel that extra time has given you the period in training to get a bit more experience ahead of this big fight to end the year?
Yeah, definitely. We had a long camp for the Okolie fight. You know, we trained for the 12 rounds, so it's put me in good stead for this. The recovery time for the injury wasn't long, so I was back punching 6 weeks after the injury. So it's time to go.
And do you feel, obviously, as I say, a massive fight and big for you for a big 2020? Do you feel this can open up a lot of doors for you moving forward?
Definitely, yeah, absolutely. Massive year next year after this.
Perfect. Richard, great year for you this year and a great way to end the year with a big fight.
Yeah.
How are you feeling?
Yeah, I'm feeling good. You know, I'm happy of the opportunities I received this year. You know, just stepping up to the plate for Tommy McCarthy back in March. Got the win for Crispin and Smith not too long ago, got the win as well. And, you know, what would it end the year perfectly would be with me getting the win over Jack Massey with the British title as well at stake. So what more could I want?
Definitely. And obviously, if you get the win Thursday night, it's a huge belt, winning the British title. Do you feel there's a lot of big fights out there for you in 2020?
Yeah, there's a lot of big fights out there in 2020, but we're not going to overlook Jack Massey. We've prepared for him like he's a true veteran, and we're ready to take the win and get on with it.
Perfect. And how do you see the fight going?
I don't see the fight going longer than 6 rounds.
Jack?
Yeah, no more than 6 rounds for me.
I don't see the round going past 6 rounds, but I trained for 15 rounds. So we're ready for whatever. If Jack wants to box, I can box. If he wants to fight, I can fight. I believe I can beat him in every single department on the inside. And if he wants to have a cookout and see who's the best chef, then I'll beat him for a Sunday roast cookout. And if I lose on that, I'll put him in the oven. Afterwards.
He's confident. Get ready for a boxing match.
Whatever you want, you know. So I'm ready for whatever. I'm looking forward to it. I respect Jack Massey as a fighter. I respect him for taking a fight. You know,
you
for
took
me
the fight.
To pardon?
So, you took the fight.
Yeah, we both took the fight. I respect him for taking the fight. And I'm just ready to put in a showcase of my skills, and my my reservoir so far has prepped me perfectly for this fight so far. So far, so good. I'm happy.
Good luck.
Thank you. Cheers.
An exciting way to end the UK boxing scene for us. As I say, a great year. It will be 40 shows promoted in 7 different countries, up to 370 fights. And this is a great stage for all of these guys. The JD Next Gen series has been a great building platform to move on to the Saturday Fight Night cards. And everyone on these top tables will have a great 2020 ahead. We'd like to say a big thanks, obviously, to our partners, JD, StubHub, and William Hill, and to our broadcast partners, Sky Sports and DAZN. All of this wouldn't be possible without them. Sold out, completely sold out, only place to watch on Sky Sports and DAZN on Thursday night. We look forward to seeing you at the weigh-in tomorrow. We're going to break for head-to-head and one-on-one interviews, and thank you all for coming today.
Do you want me to roll all the way through?
Yeah, you've got to lay across the floor and like that.
Down here, Lufa, that's been perfect. Bring it a bit closer, that's it, perfect. Craig Chad down there, please. Front, Richard, Chad, the net. Face to face.
Ha 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 ha!